What's up, guys? I'm Ishmael from Automod, and I'm here to talk about balloon payments when it comes to car finance. In the world of vehicle finance, there are several ways in which a car can be bought, sold, or traded. In most circumstances, cars are purchased through the bank by applying for and obtaining a loan. Depending on the financial situation of the customer and the nature of the transaction, these finance deals and loan agreements may be structured in several ways. In this video, we'll be taking a closer look into the world of balloon payments. We will unpack what they are, how they're used in the world of vehicle finance. We will also try to shed some light on the positive and negative aspects of balloon payments. Some vehicle, loan, or finance agreements are structured with a balloon payment. From the onset, these can make new vehicle offers seem quite enticing to some consumers. Balloon payments may work for some people, but they can also cause their own problems for others. Now, what is a balloon payment? A balloon payment is essentially a lump sum cash payment that is linked to a vehicle finance loan agreement. This payment is often due closer to the end of the vehicle loan period and is considerably larger than the usual monthly repayments. Balloon payments are usually to reduce the monthly fixed payments for the period of the loan. They are generally used by people who have a good credit score and a substantial annual income. Is a balloon payment a good idea? Well, for some people, they would agree to balloon payment terms because they believe that by the time the loan period is up, they would have had some form of an increase in their income. The balloon payment terms only make the monthly repayments more affordable over the loan period, and this makes the new vehicle purchase seem like a great idea. The bulk cash balloon payment is then only due in 4 to 5 years, depending on the terms, and a lot of people believe that they will have enough time to accumulate capital to pay off the balloon payment when the loan period is up. It is important, however, to note that balloon payments aren't more affordable. They just spread the total cost of the vehicle out differently. If there is no guarantee that your income will increase in time, then you should rather choose a finance option that suits your current pocket without creating future debt. Now, what are the benefits of a balloon payment? When it comes to buying a new car, a balloon payment can be advantageous to people who know their wealth will increase. This allows the buyer to reduce their monthly fees on the new car for the entire period. Reducing the initial monthly payments might also allow some people to buy into a higher vehicle category. What happens if I don't have the capital to pay off my balloon payment? So you have come to the end of the loan period and you now sit in a situation whereby you now have to pay the balloon payment. If you don't have the capital to do this, there are two simple options. Option number one, you may sell or trade in your current car through a dealership, and hopefully you will be able to cover the balloon payment with the money you get from the sale of your car. Option number two, you might have a good credit record from paying the car off and the bank might let you refinance the outstanding amount. But what are the pros of balloon payments? There's lower monthly payments, more affordable short-term capital. There are also cons. And what are these? Costs of the loan can be higher than the normal vehicle finance. Balloon finance is more risky. If you don't have the money to pay the lump sum at the end of the term, there is no guarantee that you will be offered a refinancing option. At the end of the day, it is up to the buyer to ensure that they are in control of their finances and are well informed about the finance options that are best suited to them.